is a short video we're producing to help you with the installation of your Wyckomar UV water purifier. We just set up a test mock-up system in the factory here. You'll hear some background noise. Don't worry about it. We're going to use as the demonstration our UV700 system, which includes a dual filter set 20-inch and the UV reaction chamber itself. There's also included is flex tubing and various connectors we use for the job. The idea of the video is to help homeowners and installers with a simple installation plan for the UV700 system and pretty much any other Wyckomar UV system. A couple things you want to take into consideration before you start the installation is your location of the system itself. It's going on the incoming water line into the home. You want to have access to your main water shutoff, and you want to have enough space that you can install the unit. One important consideration is headspace above the unit. You need enough headspace above the unit equivalent to the length of the UV chamber in order to insert and remove the UV lamp. So it's an important consideration, may require some thinking. The idea of using flex pipe we've included in the system kit gives you a lot of flexibility with locating your installation. Because you have flex pipe, you can pick and choose anywhere in your incoming line that you want to install the system at. As it comes out of the box, you're going to want to check for all the components. And as you get everything ready, what you want to do is make sure that each of the connectors that has a thread on it is T-taped with Teflon tape. It's better to do it before you start the installation rather than as you go, because once all the connections are T-taped, makes the installation a lot easier and a lot faster, to tell you the truth. Now that we've got Teflon tape on all of the threads, we're going to lay out our location of our filter set. So we've removed the sumps. This is just the bracket for the filters. And we're going to decide where it goes in our line. We'll use a small level to make sure that it's level. After we've got level marked, mark with a pencil where the holes are going to go for the bracket mounting. Pretty simple stuff. Now that we have the location of the filter set decided upon, it's time to cut the pipe. Be sure to turn your water off at the main first. Now that we've taken the pipe out, we've cut the pipe, take a piece of sandpaper. You just want to deburr the pipe all the way around, and this ensures that the compression fitting will fit properly on the pipe. Just deburr all the way around. Once that's done, the second compression fitting can go right on that inlet pipe. That's the connection that you're going to hook the unit to. The second compression fitting goes on the other end. It's got the valve. We've now got the in and out on the pipe. The next step is to install the filter bracket. The screws are included in the kit. You'll need a Robertson screwdriver. Sets up your filter set. Now you can see we've installed on the inlet side using a flexible tube. And the use of flexible tube, whether it's stainless like this, whether it's braided, or whether it's PEX, anything like that you can use. But the idea of using something flexible is when you need to do an odd shape like you see here, makes it easier. So you can use just about any kind of connector. In this demo, we happen to be using stainless flexible tubes. The next thing you want to connect is the outlet of the filter set. In the kit, there's a long flexible tube, and what you want to do to get the shape right on this one that's in the box, that's what you want it to look like. And what we do with this one is it's outgoing from the filter set this is what will connect the UV chamber itself. Now, to install the UV chamber itself, you want to take one of the pipe mounts and put it on the UV chamber between these two fittings. It helps hold the unit up on the wall. And to install it, we would first connect the bottom flex pipe that we just installed a minute ago so we can space the UV chamber properly. What you want to do is just make it straight. Once you've got it straightened, you want to mark the center. You want to mark the center of the pipe holder, and you want to mark the top of the pipe holder. That'll just allow us to install the pipe holders on the wall simply and easily. After you've marked the location of the first pipe hanger, you want to mark the location for the second. Just take a level and drop that center line down. That'll give you the location for the center of the lower pipe hanger. Now, to install the pipe hangers on the wall, pipe hangers in the kit, screws in the kit, regular Robertson screwdriver. Here's your upper pipe mount. Same thing with the lower. After both pipe mounts are installed, you can install the chamber itself. Connect the bottom outlet tube again. Hand tight. Snap the chamber into both pipe holders. And then seal them up. And there's your chamber installed. Next step is to install the filter housings. There's a seal that goes in each of the filter housings. It should be in there. Just check to make sure it's seated properly. You're not going to install the filter cartridges at this time, just the housings itself. Your simple spin on, hand tight. Check for the seal. Spin on, now, hand tight. Before we install it, we want to make sure that the seal is at the top of the quart sleeve, and in the bottom of the quart sleeve, we've included a spring. The spring prevents the lamp from breaking through the bottom of the quart. It's important to be in the quart sleeve. To install the quart sleeve, remove the compression nut at the top of the UV chamber. And you'll notice I'm using a piece of the plastic the quart was wrapped in order to hold it, again, to avoid fingerprints. Quart sleeve is installed straight and slowly. The seal that's on the top of the quart sleeve will fit right into the groove at the top of the fitting. The compression nut goes back on. The compression nut seals down that seal and makes the chamber watertight. The UV lamp is an easy install. Unwrap it from the plastic. Again, don't handle it with your fingers. Handle it by the ceramic ends if possible. In order to get it up to where you need to get it, use a piece of plastic again. It goes right in the quart sleeve. Sits and bounces on the spring inside the quart sleeve that I mentioned earlier. The four pins will be sticking out slightly. The next step is to install the ballast, which controls the lamp. Again, the screws are included in the kit, standard Robertson screwdriver. You want to mount the ballast above the water line to prevent any water intrusion into the electronics. And the next step is to install the connect the electronics to the UV lamp. It's very simple. Inside the blue cap, there's a ground lug, and there's a white lamp pin connector. The ground lug fits on the ground post that's on top of the UV chamber. The nut is included in the kit. That provides a ground for the unit. The white lamp pin connector goes on the lamp. Gently push it on. The blue cap sits atop, hand tight, and you'll want to loop the cable down to act as a drip loop so no water can infiltrate again. That's basically the final installation. What you want to do is just simply go over all the connections to make sure everything is tight and water sealed. Hand tight is usually more than adequate, including the filter housings. Make sure you include all the fittings that you've put T-tape on. Hand tight, water tight. And you also want to pop that blue cap again and ensure that the compression nut is hand tight down against the seal. Again, that makes the chamber watertight, and that's going to be important. That should do it. In order to put the unit in production, obviously this valve is in the open position here, closed position here. What you'll want to do is put the valve in the open position and slowly open your water main valve in order to fill the system with water. There's pressure release buttons on top of the filters in order to let the air out as the water flows through. Check for leaks. You're in business.